Hey guys, Vikram Brolkar from the test automation team here. We know that organizations aren't going to be able to automate everything day one, and so UiPath Test Manager provides the ability to perform manual testing. Being an automation company, we want to also make sure that you can accelerate manual testing as much as possible, and so we do this in three ways. First, we provide an integration with our documentation tool called Task Capture that allows testers to record their actions to not only create documentation with screenshots, but also be able to import the actual manual test step definitions directly from a Task Capture recording. Second, when test data is defined at design time, you can input it as clipboard data, such that when a tester is actually executing it during runtime, the test data is already available in the user's clipboard. Finally, testers can also leverage UiPath attended automation to perform various administrative work. In UiPath Test Manager, manual testing first begins by defining a requirement. The requirement here will be validating the cart functionality of the J Pet Store website. After requirements are created, users can go in and assign test cases to them. When a test case is created, it doesn't have any automated test steps or manual test steps. In order to add manual test steps, a user can simply decide to document the test case with Task Capture. Task Capture can be downloaded locally on the tester's machine, and if it's already downloaded, it can be opened from Test Manager. To start capturing, a user just clicks Start Capture. They can leverage the Pause and Resume feature to ensure their environment is ready and prepared, and then they can just record the manual steps. The tester can go in and then verify that all of the actions are representative. They can go in and update the title and according description. Once all the fields have been updated, testers can just simply export the results back to Test Manager. To import the steps into the Manual Steps field, you can select Create Steps from Recording. We see all the steps updated here. Once the steps are populated, testers can go in and update the expected behavior as well as the clipboard data. Let's take a look at what the clipboard data does. So here, for example, we are dynamically entering some specific test data quantity. We can replace that with open brackets clipboard and enter that data that we need to paste into the quantity field down here. Let's take a look at how we can actually execute this during runtime. First, we'll have to navigate over to the Test Sets tab and create a new test set. Once a test set's created, we can go ahead and add the relevant test cases. Once the test cases are assigned, we can then choose to execute it. The manual steps are going to appear in its own pop-up window, and we'll be able to execute them in a manual fashion. So first, we can click Fish. As a comment, I can put any comment I want in the tester field. In addition, I have the ability to upload an attachment. So how can I actually get that attachment? Well, this is where our attended automation comes into play. Here, I can set a specific hotkey to start my automation. I can also customize my file name or take an OCR of the screenshot to copy something to my clipboard. So with that, let me go ahead and hit the hotkey. When I'm ready to capture a screenshot, you'll see my cursor has changed to red. I can just highlight a picture of what I want to capture. The details are OCR'd, so if I need that, it's in my clipboard, but then I can just upload the attachment. The attachment's saved to my documents page, and I can upload it accordingly. When I get to this field of updating quantity and setting the quantity to 2, I can just highlight it and paste that value was already in my clipboard. Back in my test results, I can view all of the various results, see exactly what happened, open the execution log, view any tester comments, and the appropriate attachments that were uploaded along the way. If a defect needs to be created, I can go ahead and create that defect in my associated defect management system. And that summarizes manual testing. Till next time, bye.